I'd like you guys to hear a song that has power and meaning. Yeah, it's Father's Day, but this song is for everybody, especially dads today, because we need to hear this over and over and over again.
Hello, my name is Regret. I'm pretty sure we have met. Every single day of your life, I'm the whisper inside that won't let you forget. Hello, my name is Defeat. I know you recognize me. Just when you think you can win, I'll drag you right back down again till you've lost all belief. Oh, these are the lies, and I have believed them for the very last time. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I've been saved, I've been changed, I have been set free. Amazing grace is the song I sing. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I am no longer defined by all the wreckage behind. The one who makes all things new has proven it. Just take a look at my life. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King. I've been saved, I've been changed, I have been set free. Amazing grace is the song I sing. Hello, my name is Child of the One True King.
That video is by Matthew West. Hello, my name is. Just in case YouTube does not allow us to put this in, sometimes they say, nope, can't have that video up. So just in case you want to rewatch that, go on YouTube and type that in. Lights, please. Camera. Ha ha. So, guys, today I want to do a reminder sermon. This is a reminder about who you are. Somehow, guys tend to be viewed as strong, and you know, and I'm not talking about smell. But they're supposed to have confidence and can't really get hurt, and they're perceived as emotionally neutral, and they don't really have emotions, and if they do, you know, they don't let them out. Have you heard those perceptions before? They're lies. They're brutal lies. And I know guys, we say the same thing about women. So, oh, they're so emotional. You've heard those terms before, right? Women are all emotional. Women, are you? That's right. It's not a gender issue. It's not a gender issue. Today I want to remind guys, you're allowed to be emotional. Women, let your guy be emotional. For if you don't, you are actually suppressing a God gift. God has created us as emotional people. We're not to live from our emotions, ever, but they do reflect the thoughts and attitudes of our heart, often. They show what we're thinking about. And sometimes we try and control things. And unfortunately, in the last 2 years, maybe 3 years, I've discovered something about emotions that I never thought possible as a guy. I didn't realize through past pains, I've shared that with you guys before, but because of past pains and now facing the reality of what that hurt has done to me and how it has suppressed, without me knowing it, my body suppressed emotions. And so I was never able to deal with issues in the past. I've discovered that even our body, so fearfully and wonderfully made, and this may sound weird to you, but that's okay. I'm just sharing my journey with you. In my journey of trying to understand healing, one little area that was quite unique, and I'd love to explore more, is the idea that our cells, our physical cells, can actually retain memory. Doesn't mean it can't change. But there is something that affects us, and we don't even know. And Papa God's healing me. Amen. He's healing you too. Amen. Especially as your mind is being renewed. Guys, I'm going to pick on you this morning because it's Father's Day. And usually you're supposed to have this majestic King David and Goliath story for a Sunday morning on Father's Day because we've got to build up the guy. Well, guess what? You know the story, so I don't have to repeat it. So let's get into some real meat and potatoes. As fathers, our kids observe. Do as I say, not as I do, is an often used phrase. Or just because I said so, you know. Don't argue with me right now. I'm into that stage. It's not good. If you discover that people learn more from observing than hearing you, that could have a tremendous effect. I grew up in a home where there was much volume. My mother was a screamer, and I refused to be like that. I've learned through God. I don't know how he did it. He just kind of did the weird protection thing. So growing up, I had a passive dad, good dad, gentle, and he showed me he loved me a lot. I knew when he gave me a hug, he really meant it. That was really cool. I observed that. He didn't say it a whole lot, but he showed it to me. In our own families, especially for young parents, if you're parenting now, your words matter, but your actions matter more. And I'm seeing this as more true than ever as I do funerals. I'm standing up front or sitting in a chair hearing eulogy after eulogy after eulogy of how a person lived their lives. The hopes, the joys, and once in a while, really honest regrets sneak their way in. And they're real. And people are emotional. You're allowed to be. Our words matter. Our actions matter more. And our actions flow from what we believe. Every single one of us, your actions flow completely from what you believe. Well, how can I change my belief? Let Papa God do that for you. You can't do it. So today, to encourage us to live out who we really are so that Jesus can be observed in our lives, I want to show you something about who you are in Christ. Some of these verses you'll know. There they are, so I can not have to go through each click. But these are the ones we're going to zoom in on today. And I'm going to try and go pretty quick. I've got to beat the Baptists to the restaurant, so. I'm kidding. If you want your kids or anyone to copy something about you, may it be the attitude of Christ. And let your mind hear this today. I want you to hear how much in Christ you are. You probably know it. So what? Guys tend to forget a lot often. You know, our little boxes. We pull out the box Sunday morning, and we live in that box. And then once we leave, we put the box away, and it's lunchtime box. And, you know, and then home box. And then we have the nothing box. You ever hear of the nothing box? That's a great video if you've seen it online. It's awesome. There really is a nothing box. Anyway, what are you thinking about? Nothing. All right, anyway. Let's go for the identity box. It's so easy to get dragged down the duties of dadhood. It's so easy to get frustrated. If we had teenagers first, we'd probably never have babies. Good chance. Galatians 3:26 says, "For you are all children of God through faith in Christ Jesus. And all who have been united with Christ in baptism have put on Christ, like putting on new clothes. There is no longer Jew, Gentile, slave or free, male or female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus." The "in" part's critical. "And now that you belong to Christ, you are true children of Abraham. You are his heirs, and God's promise to Abraham belongs to you." You and I are in Christ. We are one with him. You may not feel like it. Your emotions may not believe that, but start telling your head, your belief, you are in him. The Bible says so. Ephesians 3:4-6 says, "Being diligent to preserve the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace, there is one body, one Spirit, just as also you were called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all." I didn't make it up. Look it up yourself. Your Heavenly Father is far more involved in you than you possibly know. What if I'm an unbeliever? I don't believe all this Jesus stuff. Ha! That's funny. You think you have more control. I love that. That's really good. Just keep living your life the way you are. Papa God's in charge of your mind change, not us. Not me. You're not in charge of other people's mind change. You're not in charge of your kids growing up that they believe. It's not your responsibility. All you get to do is love with the love of Christ, but you have to know it. God's in charge of the belief and the drawing to himself, not you. Oh, but we have to save the lost. Who does? Who's in charge of saving the lost? Christ is. And if they're lost, guess what? They have a home. Or you can't be lost. And if they're blind, then God will open their eyes to see. It's his job. But you are in Christ. John 17:20-21 says, "I am praying not only for these disciples, but also for all who will ever believe in me." Well, like that. Oh, let me read that again. That's truly cool. "I am not only for these disciples, but also for all who will ever believe in me through their message. I pray that they will all be one, just as you and I are one, as you are in me, Father, and I am in you. And may they be in us, so that the world will believe you sent me." This is Jesus speaking. Let your mind hear how much in Christ you are. This is in the garden. This is pre-cross. Love that. 1 Corinthians 12:13. "For by one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, whether slaves or free, and were all made to drink of one Spirit." When were you baptized? And don't give me a calendar date. You were baptized, immersed into Christ when? At the cross. And when else before that? We find it in Ephesians. Before the foundations of the world. What about my choice? You talk to your parents about that. Talk to your parents. Did I have the choice to get born? Really? How much free will have you got? Good luck with that one. Listen to this. This is 1 Corinthians 12:13 in another translations. Some of us are Jews, some are Gentiles, some are slaves, and some are free, but we have all been baptized into one body by one Spirit, and we all share the same Spirit. No one here is independent. It's an impossibility to be independent, because if you are independent, then you are a god. And that is an impossibility. For Christ created all things, and he holds all things together. We're going to get to that a little later. It's really good. Romans 12:5. So it is with Christ's body. We are many parts of one body, but we all belong to each other. You're not even independent from each other here. We see the nucleus of a family, mom, dad, and kids. That's an example of a family. Not everybody has kids, but there's still a family, husband and wife. Individuals, you have extended families, folks. The nucleus of that is one picture, but it gets bigger. And in the body of Christ, Christ is the head of the body. But we're all part of the body, and there's one Spirit in that body. It is Jesus Christ, the life of God. He is one with you and me. Jesus is life. Cover that one later, too. I'm jumping ahead. I got to be careful here. Ephesians 1:22-23. God has put all things under the authority of Christ and has made him head over all things for the benefit of the church. And the church is his body. It is made full and complete by Christ, who fills all things everywhere with himself. Ephesians 1:22-23. It is made full and complete by Christ, who fills all things everywhere with himself. This has ramifications. I'll let the Holy Spirit teach you on that one. Romans 6:4. Therefore, I love this, we have been buried with him through baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in that newness of life. You have new life. Now walk in it. Men, at home, probably the most difficult place to practice this stuff. It's, for me, it's the dinner table. It's hard because anybody experience that? Anyone? You love what?
I love that.
Yeah, but that's the women can handle that. Seriously. Better than me. It's like, I can hear one person at a time. I can't. They're having a conversation and they ask me a question. Like, how am I supposed to handle all these frequencies? And so emotionally. And then this voice comes out that does not come from my spirit. And frustration. Quiet! Settle down! And for years, I've been learning to dethrone that voice. I haven't been completely successful. It's challenged often. This is just mine. You have your triggers, okay? Everybody has their triggers of what gets them going. May the Holy Spirit show you that those triggers are not a reflection of your life in Christ. Those triggers are not your identity. Your name is Jesus Christ in you. You saw a great video on that. You are righteous right now because of Christ being your life. One of the biggest setbacks for me growing up was I believed in eternal life. I believed that when I said the prayer, that once, when I die, then I get eternal life. But now I've discovered eternal life is a person. His name is Jesus Christ. And I have eternal life now. Forever. You can't separate us. It's impossible. Scripture says so. You got a pretty good bargain. He did it all. He went ahead to the cross. Didn't even ask your permission. He died for you. You died with him. He rose. You rose. Then he invites you to believe. And when you do, radical change. It affects you. But the belief comes from him. 1 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. The old things passed away. Behold, all things have come new. You are a new creation in Christ, a new species. Colossians 1:27. For God wanted them to know that the riches and glory of Christ are for you Gentiles too. So this is the secret. Christ lives in you. This gives you the assurance of sharing his glory. Your name matters. Well, if you are one with Jesus Christ and you share the name with him, I want to tell you something about his name. I'm going to go pretty quick, okay? A couple of items I'll highlight. Jesus is called Advocate, the one who speaks on your behalf, your helper. He lives in you. You need help? I need help at the dinner table and in roundabouts. You clearly know that already. All right? So I approach these things in advance. I say, Lord, it's awesome. He's your advocate. He's the Alpha and Omega. This is the name you bear. If his name is this, it's also your name. Believe it. Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. He is your beginning. He is your end. You need not be afraid. He is a branch. You're the vine. No, he's the vine. You're the branch. But he's also called a branch. It's weird how that works. But the point is, we draw life from him. And he just flows through us as our source, as our nourishment. He produces the fruit through us. And what do we get to do? Hang there. That's it. He may even whisper something in your ear of what to do. But that's only responding. That's a joyful obedience. He's called a bridegroom. We're called the bride. There's love there. Attraction. And you are so attractive to Jesus. And he did everything to pursue you. Everything. And he won. He got your attention. He's called a builder. Not only did he create the world, built it, he's building us up in himself. That's wild. Listen to this. This is really cool. For by him, some things were created. Is that what it says? No. Listen. For by him, all things were created, both in the heavens and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things have been created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. Amen. You have nothing to be afraid of at all. You have nothing to be afraid of in sharing your emotions. Women, you need to know something about your man. Or the man you could potentially meet. We are just as emotional as you are. We are no different. We just bottle up better than you do. We are emotional beings that hurt with accusations. You may think that we're these tall pillars that can handle all the, you know, off-the-cuff remarks that dig. Guess what? They build up. They hurt. Same thing back. When a guy does that to a girl, it's exactly the same. There is no difference. Why is there separation in this? There isn't one. There's a lot of healing that has to happen in guys. We've bottled it up. Even our bodies have bottled it up, and we don't even know it. I'm just starting to discover this, okay? I'm not there yet. I hope to share this with you sometime in the future. Papa's doing an inner healing in me. It's scary and exciting. I love it. I'm terrified of it, but I love it. I know it's him. He started the process. It's all good. I've had the chance to become friends with another person who's also on a journey. And through his journey, I've received permission to become emotional. But it took somebody else to put it out there raw and real. It's like, oh, really? And suddenly the domino effect happened. Perhaps that can happen here. Perhaps. It takes a risk. Jesus is called the gift of God. He was given to us. He's called head of the body, the church. Quit saying you hate church. If you're seeing this online, because you don't go to church. So what? Don't say you hate church. The real you loves the church, the bride of Christ. Certain gatherings I can't stand. But the church, the body of Christ, is wonderful, and he's attracting you to it to meet with one another. There's been a movement of anti-church. Guess what? It's not anti-church. It's anti-legalism. The systems that control people. We've got to ditch churchianity and become authentic Christ to one another. And that takes time. He's called the Holy One of God, Emmanuel, God with us. But it's better than that now. He's God in us. He's called Judge. Oh, finally you bring up some balance to your grace teaching. Oh yeah? He'll judge. Guess how he judges you? Righteous, clean, forgiven, pure. That's his judgment, and it's final. Good news. King of kings, Lord of lords. He's called the Lamb of God. He's called the last Adam. There ain't going to be a third. The first one affected all of humanity, yes? The second one says it does equal and, if not more, much better. Interesting. Just think about it. Jesus is called life. He's called light. He's called mediator. He's called Messiah. He's called mystery, because there's a lot of mystery there. He's called rock, the bedrock of all creation, the founder of foundation. He's called savior, and in the Greek, savior is the word sotor. The word means safe. He's your safety. He's the servant of God, the good shepherd, the son of God, the son of man, the truth, the way. He's the word of God, and he is for you. When your emotions start to tell you, I feel that people are against me, maybe even God's against me, that's a lie. That voice was never generated by you, the real you, your real identity that was planted. Remember who you are. Remember. Lights?
I lose my way and I forget my name. Remind me who I am. In the mirror all I see is who I don't want to be. Remind me who I am. In the loneliest places, when I can't remember what grace is. away from your beloved. Can you help me believe it? Tell me once again who I am to you, who I am to you. Oh, tell me, yes, I forget who I am to you, but I belong. Lest I forget who I am to you, that I belong to you. Whoa, tell me once again who I am to you, who I am to you. Tell me, lest I forget who I am to you, that I belong to you.
Not been called to be a perfect parent. It's impossible. Just saying. Moms, dads, you're called to live Jesus through your unique personality that God has given you. Don't sell your kids something you aren't and then get mad at them for it. Be loved because you are. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, you are our real Father. You are the mark. You are the model. You are the one to look at. All of our earthly fathers are not to be the model, unless it's Jesus shining through. That part we can model. So today, with a mix of emotions and regrets, even tears at the loss of a dad, you are our real Father. Be our comfort for us. Be our joy. May we toss the regrets out and begin today just to live loved. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Ushers, will you come?